Hello friends, we have Ms. Pamela Kumar with us. She is the DG of Telecom Standard Development Society of India and founder, chair and vice president of Cloud Computing Innovation Council of India. Welcome ma'am to the BES Expo 2020. I'd like to ask you, what is the function of DSI, if you can tell us and briefly.
I would give it through an illustration of what TSDSI has been able to achieve. So, you know, so far we have been consumer of technology. So, technology is developed in other countries for their needs. And then they sell it here and we buy it and we try to make use of it in ways, sometimes optimally, sometimes suboptimally. To meet our needs. Whereas the direction should be different. As a consumer of technology, we should tell the vendor, please design your equipment, your technology for our needs. So an example is that there is a new, in this new era of 5G, they were defining what should be rural broadband. So the countries from North America, Europe, China, they were trying to say that in the next generation in their villages, they want 100 megabit per second on the mobile phone when they are traveling in a 125 kilometer per hour vehicle in their village. China was saying that they want uninterrupted 100 megabit per second on their mobile phone when they are traveling in a bullet train in their village. So we said our village does not have bullet train. Our village does not have expressway, highways. Our village has people. We want our people in the village, our 70% of our population, to get 100 megabit per second at affordable rates of 100 ARPU. We know our villages, there is a gram panchayat where the fiber will come. We can't afford, so the base stations, they were bringing the base station closer and closer. In order to achieve that, their requirement, they were making more and more base stations, making it more and more expensive because the people driving in the bullet train are probably able to afford to pay extra premium for that. But we want for our people in the village to give it at a lower ARPU, at a more affordable rate. So we want the base stations to be farther away. So the technology to enable this has been developed in our IITs. So we have gone to the international bodies and we have defined a new requirement called the low mobility large cell, we call it LMLC, which is for our villages, for connecting the unconnected, for providing rural connectivity, right? So we have also taken the innovations, the new type of waveforms, the new type of signaling that is being designed in our research institutes and made it part of the standard, so that now the vendors will have to design equipment which meets our needs. In short, it tries to take our needs and our requirements, make it part of the global standard. It also takes our innovations, our startups, our researchers, the innovations that are happening in our labs, and make it part of global standards.
So you were mentioning about 5G, nano and green technology.
Yeah.
So could you please tell us something about that? How it would help the society or change the scenario of the future broadcasting?
Well, so what is unique about 5G? 5G is about taking what information technology, which was in our computer, in our data centers, right, we crunching all kinds of data, doing all kinds of computation. And communication technology has been about carrying voice, carrying data, bringing all of that together. Broadcast is also a method of broadcasting information. So these happened in silos with a very specific way. Now 5G is saying that let's take all these technologies, they have become mature, and let's try to address the issues in the vertical industries like healthcare. How can we give healthcare better? How can every man who needs healthcare get it the moment he needs it, from the best doctor, right? in the most optimal way? How can education be delivered in the most effective way so that every child gets the best access to the best teacher and the best learning methodologies, right, that technology can enable? So similarly, in all the manufacturing, how can we make it globally competitive and effective and customize manufacturing to the needs of the consumers with low power consumption, not increasing the carbon footprint? So so these are this is what 5G is trying to do. So what it needs is for our IT, our communications and our broadcast industries to come together and create converged solutions which will be most optimal. So that's the vision of 5G. And nanotechnology, semiconductors is obviously, semiconductor has always been that that you keep getting better every year for half the price, one-tenth the price, the cost keeps going down and the performance keeps going up. That's the way nano has always happened, and that's what the consumer or the society has become used to. That is, every year they will get cheaper and better service and products, so that's what we are trying to enable.
And BES is an engineering society, and how BES and TSDSI can jointly go together for the betterment of the broadcasting industry?
Absolutely. I think this is the first step that we have come together in this society. There is already an initiative that we have started within TSDSI called the Broadcast Offload, where given that video is flooding the network, the cellular network, and there is a whole set of standards being defined on how video can be offloaded onto the broadcast network to make the cellular network more efficient for other applications. So there's already a study group which is working on this, and we can take that further, joining hands with BES to engage more and more people from the broadcast engineering society into this work that we are doing within TSDSI.
Any suggestion for this expo?
I think we should do joint events like Mr. Vempathy suggested. There is a big event that happens in the communications, the India Mobile Congress, where maybe BES and TSDSI and COAI can join hands, and we can have a broadcasting event along with the India Mobile Congress event, because that I think that will be a step in the right direction.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for joining us.